Hello students, today we are going to talk about improvement in the technology for using conventional sources of energy. So basically, to use the conventional source of energy, we need to improve the technology. So how we can do that? So first of all, let's talk about the biomass. So we mentioned earlier that wood has been used as a fuel for a long time in ancient time, where the gas facilities is not available at that time. If we can ensure that enough trees are planted, a continuous supply of firewood can be assured. You must also be familiar with the use of cow dung cakes as a fuel, right? So in ancient time, basically we are use wood for getting heat energy as a fuel, as well as we are using the cow dung as a fuel in ancient time. And we can get wood continuously if we are going to planted more and more trees. Given the large livestock population in India, this can be assured as a steady source of fuel. Since these fuels are plant and animals product, the source of these fuels is said to be biomass, right? Why it can be considered as the biomass? Because the fuel source is plant and animals, and that is the reason it can be considered as the biomass. Bio means living component, right? Okay, so plant and animal both are living component, that is considered as biomass. These fuels, however, do not produce much heat on burning, and lot of smoke is given out when they are burnt. So as we all know that when we are going to burn wood or do the combustion of any wood or cow dung, then what we will see, that lots of amount of smoke will going to be produced, because it does not showing the complete combustion, and because of that reason the heat energy is very less and the smoke will be very more amount, right? Therefore, technological inputs to improve the efficiency of these fuels are necessary. When wood is burnt in a limited supply of oxygen, water and volatile materials present in it get removed, and charcoal is left behind as the residue. So when you are going to burn the wood, what exactly happen? Because wood having a certain volatile materials and water as a water vapor, right? So when you are going to burn it, it will going to be removed, and left residue will be of the charcoal. Charcoal burns without flames, is comparatively smokeless, and has higher heat generation efficiency. So if you are directly use charcoal, in Gujarat we are calling it kolsa, right? So if you are going to use that for the burning purpose or to get the heat energy, then you will absorb, then you will observe that charcoal is burning without the flame, and the heat energy will be more as compared to the burning of wood. Similarly, cow dung various plant materials like the residue after harvesting the crops, vegetable waste and sewage are decomposed in the absence of oxygen to give biogas, right? So you all have gone through the biogas in a lower standard also, that biogas can be produced from the dead vegetations and the sewage material, right? Like we can have the crop harvesting residues, then vegetable waste, then sewage. They all are going to be decomposed in absence of oxygen. That is considered as the anaerobic decomposition, and it will leads to give us biogas. Since the starting material is mainly cow dung, it is popularly known as gobar gas also. Biogas is produced in a plant. We have given the figure of the biogas plant. So here we can go through this figure to understand the biogas plant, or which we can also called gobar gas plant, because mainly the material which is used in this, that is the cow dung. So basically this kind of plant will be there. Underground pit has been dug. Here there is an inlet, and here there will be the outlet, right? So slurry of the cow dung, sewage material, dead vegetations, etc. will be poured from this portion. It will go underground, and the decomposition will going to be takes place in absence of oxygen, because here you can see all the side the plant will be packed, so that is not getting that much amount of the oxygen, so there is a lack of oxygen. The decomposition will start going to be takes place, and the gas will be generated, and that gas can be taken out from this gas outlet. So let's say understand the theory. The plant has a dome-like structure built with bricks. So with the help of brick, we can build a dome-like structure. A slurry of cow dung and water is made in the mixing tank from where it is fed into the digester. So it can be considered as the digester tank and it can be considered as the inlet, right? So from here, the slurry will going to be inlet into the digester tank. Now, the digester is sealed chamber in which there is no oxygen. As I told you, this all the outlet will be sealed out. So there will be no oxygen. So anaerobic microorganisms that do not require oxygen decompose or break down complex compounds of the cow dung slurry. And it takes a few days for the decomposition process to be complete and generate gases like methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen and hydrogen sulfide. And these all gases can be considered as the biogas. The biogas is stored in the gas tank above the digester from which they are drawn through pipes for use. So here you can observe in the figure that the gas will going to be produced. It obviously lighter in weight, so it will goes upward. From the gas outlet which is connected with the pipeline, it will directly transport it where it need to be used. So biogas is an excellent fuel as it contains up to 75% of methane, and methane showing a complete combustion, it is very good combustible substance. So it burns without smoke, leaves no residue like ash in wood, charcoal and coal burning. So it is very good source of burning because it will shows the complete combustion, it does not create any smoke and it will not leave the residue just like wood, charcoal and coal. Its heating capacity is high. Biogas is also used for lightning. For generating light also biogas we can use. The slurry left behind is removed periodically and used as excellent manure. So whatever the slurry left after the decomposition, whatever the slurry left, it will going to be taken out and it can be used as a manure to reach the nitrogen and phosphorus in the soil. The large scale utilization of bio waste and sewage material provide a safe and efficient method of waste disposal besides supplying energy and manure, right? So basically if you are going to see the advantages of biogas, then one advantage that we can dispose the waste material, as well as from the disposed waste material we can also get the fuel. So the and also the leftover slurry can also be used as a manure to replenish the soil. So these all are the advantages of the biomass.